head down to the coin toss. Brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. Wilkerson is on the field to kick this one off, and everyone in the stadium is ready for this game to get started. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. McClain's overall ability, Herbie, has got to drive you crazy if you're a defensive coach.
Yeah, you look at a defensive coordinator trying to slow this guy down, it's next to impossible. He can do so many different things, and today they're going to try to put pressure on him, because if you sit back, he just makes too many things happen.
Gains his way to the 40-yard line. They go with the option and pick up the first down.
Yeah, and that was a situation where the quarterback knew he could pick up the first down if he kept it himself. That's a good decision.
From their own 40-yard line, it's first down. Quick throw, caught by the fullback. About a 5-yard pickup on the old play-action pass.
That brings him second and 5.
It's second down, 5 to go. Ball on the 45-yard line. So he keeps it, and he gets a big first down.
The quarterback made a very good decision here not to pitch. He saw a break in the defense and just hit it for a big gain.
Runs it left for a decent gain. The option to the tailback good for about 4 yards.
That brings him second and 5.
From the 40-yard line, it's second down. He's scrambling. There's a very impressive open field tackle.
Call it a game of 2 yards. Third down. Upper position quarterback.
Well, after that injury, we'll get to see the backup quarterback here. Out here, knocked out of bounds at the 16-yard line.
This guy has that innate ability to get just enough distance from a defender to make a completion possible. You don't see it from every receiver, but this guy's got it.
First and 10, ball on the 16. Up the middle for a nice gain.
That'll make it second and 4.
This is the 8th play of this drive. He's pushed out of bounds at the 10-yard line. And they'll look to convert here on another third down. Throws it away.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
This will make it a field goal game. It's up, and it is good.
Even though they gave up a field goal here, that defense is feeling pretty good about themselves right now. It could have just as easily been a touchdown.
The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. And he got all of this one. Great kick. He's tackled at the 23-yard line. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with 5 wideouts. He's got it out to his tight end. He's taken down around the 30-yard line. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. And down he goes at the 39. He kept it himself and picked up a good-looking first down.
Great execution and a good decision there by the quarterback. First down, but he saw that no one was open, so he made the right decision to tuck it and run.
Short yardage situation here. It's second down and one. His way to about the 42.
You talk about a dual threat guy. This guy can hurt you in the air or on the ground.
Clancy takes a handoff. Runs it right. Nice pickup. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Down right around the 32-yard line. He's tackled right around the 20.
Well, the quarterback's able to find a soft spot in the defense, and he threw an accurate ball for a solid pickup.
From the 20-yard line, first down. Inside the 10, and he's taken down at the 1-yard line. This is the 9th play of this drive. Bring him down at the 5-yard line.
The defense was just all over that play. It didn't fool anybody.
They're at the 5. Second down. He's going to try and scramble. Nice move, and he scores.
Shouldn't have surprised these guys to see the run coming at them, but they just couldn't stop it. It's very important for this offense to get on track early in this game, because if they find their rhythm early, it's very, very difficult for the defense to slow them down.
And he adds the extra point. A nice 10-play, 78-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
Boy, this offense right now is just being physical, really controlling the line of scrimmage, and it's opening up some nice big lanes for the running back.
A tight, low-scoring game in that first 15 minutes. Let's see if things open up in the second quarter. The Bulldogs lead 7-3. James, everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Back to the action here in the second quarter. It's been a good one and a tight one at this point. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Tackle at the 25. From their own 25-yard line, second down. They make the stop around the 36-yard line. Makes it out to about the 49.
That makes a first and 10. First and 10. Ball on the 49. He's under pressure. Quick release. Tight end. Incomplete.
You got to give the receiver a chance to make the play. That was just underthrown.
That makes it second and 10. Tackle made around the 49-yard line. Third down, and they need to get it down to the 39.
Okay, just like that. Just like that.
Light seven. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. And he's tackled at the 43-yard line.
I know the defense would have liked to have prevented such a big game, but the important thing is that they held and brought up fourth down.
Chance, the return man. Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20. With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. They spread the field in the gun with five wide receivers. Now he's scrambling. He's out to the 30, and he's shoved out of bounds at the 34. From their own 34-yard line. First down. Straight run. Nothing going on there.
That makes it second and 10.
They'll spread the field with five wide. Quick throw. That one goes for good yardage and a first down.
Yeah, that's just a nice gain on second down.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 44-yard line. He fights forward to about the 46.
That's good for a gain of 2 yards. That makes it second and 8.
They come out on an empty backfield. He goes out of bounds at the 47.
That'll bring up third and 2.
It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. Gains his way to the 33-yard line.
You know that saying, get your keys out, because we're on a drive? This offense right now is on a drive. I mean, this is their third first down. They're doing just about anything they want, and they're really starting to wear the psyche of this defense down.
Here they go on the draw, and they'll lose yards.
He just never had a chance to get any running room. The defense was on him almost as soon as the ball was snapped.
Second and 14. Ball on the 37-yard line. Complete. He's got room. He's taken down around the 28-yard line. It's the ninth play of the drive. He's on the run. Ball is loose. Fumble. The defense scoops it. They work hard, and they got the turnover.
This is what it's all about. Defense taking advantage of an opportunity. They're pouncing on the loose ball.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. He gets rid of this one.
It's second and 10.
Ball on the 32-yard line.
Looks left, finding his tailback. He's gobbled up in the backfield. He's under some heat. He's wrapped up for the sack.
I think this defensive end is doing a great job of getting after the quarterback, not only with the sack in this case, but it seems like the entire game he's done a good job of creating pressure, making this quarterback feel him, and almost giving him happy feet back there. He doesn't seem to be in rhythm and almost seems to be throwing the football, feeling the pressure and almost creating nerves on the quarterback.
So no luck on that drive as they go three and out. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. They'll line up with five wide receivers. Now he tries to buy some time. And down he goes at the 49.
The Bulldogs are going to call their second timeout.
From their own 49-yard line, second down. They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a five wide outlook. It's caught. First down, and he's out of bounds. They call it a catch, but the booth signaled down to the referee that they'd like to take another peek at this.
Man, as I see this play again, it really looks like he made the correct call on the field.
After reviewing the play, the ruling on the field stands.
Well, I think the play warranted a review, but the call on the field stands. Scrambled. Decides to slide. And a nice catch there before he stepped out of bounds. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 15-yard line. Has some daylight. The five. What a play to set him up with a first and goal. Five wide. He's scrambling. And he's going to come up with a sack. He just blew past the blockers and dragged the quarterback down.
Boy, excellent play by the defense here. A few extra seconds, and those receivers might have been open.
Kicks away, and it's footsie uprights.
They're probably just going to squib this kick. I don't think they want to see the return man create lightning before halftime.
And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions.
He gets out to about the 28-yard line.
We head into halftime with both offenses struggling. The Bulldogs lead 10-3.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Bruce Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. We've been looking forward to this game all week, and it has lived up to billing. A close game. You feel like that it's going to be a great second half. And, boy, we've got the perfect guys in the booth. What a reward today for Nessler and Herb Street to get this game.
Well, you know, it's not a secret, Reese. They get the best game every week that we think's on the schedule, right? So they got this grave. It's great. It's close. It's going back and forth. I mean, what a treat to watch one of the best games of the year just unfolding in front of us. And more importantly, to hear the silky smooth sounds of Kirk Herbstreit and Brad Nessler. Does it get any better?
David's ready to get back on that couch, get the remote, get all the games dialed up to watch what's going on around the country. time to get you back for your second half. Brad and Kirk, ready to roll.
And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set for the second half. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The quarterback leads the offense back out onto the field as we get set to resume play. And he's tackled after positive yardage. From their own 29-yard line, it's second down. Quick throw out to the receiver, incomplete. Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun, five wide receivers. Scrambling around. Washington, back to return it. He's tackled at the 43. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Gets out to around the 45. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 45. Blackburn takes it left. Knocked out of bounds at the 29.
That makes it first and 10.
Quickly to the tight end. Brought down around the 17-yard line. It's first and 10. Ball on the 17. Fires out to his receiver. And that sets them up with a first and goal.
That makes it first and goal.
They're crowding the line. He's in for the touchdown. They'll line up for the extra point in an attempt to tie the game. And he tacks on the extra point. A five-play, 57-yard drive, and a touchdown's a result.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass, just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
And a 10-10 tie in this game. And he makes it out to about the 17-yard line. Now's when you start to approach each drive thinking that if you take the lead, then the momentum you gain feels that much more powerful. He makes his way to about the 28. From their own 28-yard line, it's first down. They come out in a five-wide set. He's going to try and scramble. They'll make the sack.
This quarterback has to do a better job of avoiding the rush, because sacks can be real drive killers.
Three down, three down. Three down. second down at the 36-yard line. So they pick up quite a few yards on that play, Kirk.
Well, that was an excellent route, and he did a great job of holding on to the football.
So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. Second down, six to go. Ball on the 44. Complete, brought down, nothing doing. Dumps it complete to the halfback, over the middle. And he stopped behind the line. And they back up 3 yards on that play.
Really, they just had nowhere to go after the catch.
They've got 10 guys up. It looks like they're going to try to block this one. He really got a hold of that one. Gets out to about the 21. And offense is back on the field after running the ball very well on their last drive.
This offensive line really opened up some big gaps for the running back last time.
He's tackled around the 19-yard line.
The offense knows that the linebackers are cheating up a little bit on the run. They can get some protection. They might want to open up a little bit of space for some passes underneath.
Second down, about 12 yards to go. Ball on the 19-yard line. Zips it to the tight end. They'll bring him down at about the 29-yard line. It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. Wideout makes the first down catch. So he keeps it, and he gets a big first down.
The quarterback made a very good decision here not to pitch. He saw a break in the defense and just hit it for a big gain.
First and 10, ball on their own 46. So at the end of three, this one's all even at 10. In this very pivotal fourth quarter. Gains his way to the 43-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 43-yard line. Bring him down in the backfield. Loss of one there for the halfback. Hey, 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 hey. there. Copeland gains a good 6 yards there on the option. That'll make it 35. And so it's another third down upcoming here. Here's a screen pass. Gets it to the back. Tackle made around the 40-yard line. The pressure. Big stop by the defense. You've got to be aware that capitalizing on this drive is crucial. You want to take the pressure off you and put it on your opponent. Strike to the receiver, and he's tackled around the 46-yard line. Nothing going on that play.
Well, here I think the quarterback needs to be a little bit more patient in the pocket. That way he can allow his receivers to get downfield a little bit before he throws it.
Second and 8. Ball on the 46-yard line. Now he's scrambling. They bring the quarterback down. Right around the 42-yard line. Washington is back to receive. Tackle at the 20. Well, if you like defensive football, you got to love this one.
Well, neither one of these offenses have gotten really into a rhythm the entire ball game. Still the fourth quarter to be played. It's anybody's game.
This is when things get a little prickly. You need your playmakers to really come through here. Just under 3 to go in regulation. Maxwell takes a handoff. He's to the 40, and he's shoved out of bounds at the 41. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 41. Here's the halfback on the screen. He's pushed out of bounds around the 37-yard line. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 37. Trying to set up a little screen, gets it to his tailback. And they make the stop right around the 28-yard line.
That brings up second and 1.
Taken down at about the 11. From the 11-yard line, first down. Just over a minute left. And down he goes at the 8-yard line. They need about 3 yards to get the first down here on third down. Looks like someone got a head start on the line.
False start. Offense.
It'll be third down again after that penalty.
Yeah, now they have more yards to pick up for the first down.
So it's coming down to the kicking game. This to give them the lead. The kick is up, and it is good. Kick, and they might just kick it short and prevent a long return. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Yeah, the defensive coordinator made it a priority to put some pressure on this quarterback.
Great job by the defense tonight, getting into the backfield and creating issues for this line.
They also have that one takeaway.
This offense hasn't had any trouble moving the ball on the ground.
And that's always been a very positive thing. It'll keep the defense honest, and they won't be able to just play the pass.
They'll just need to have one final solid defensive series, and they'll put the seal on this game. Even in a game this close, I think it's going to take something very unexpected to change the outcome. But that doesn't mean it won't happen. Out of bounds at the 29-yard line. Chance. Gains about 4 yards there. It's second down, 6 yards to go. Ball on the 29-yard line. He's hit and taken down. They were very fortunate to come up with that pass.
Not the smartest throw that he could have made, but it worked. It just makes you a little nervous when he lets that thing go.
One last play, folks. It's time to find out how far he can throw it and see if this game becomes one of the all-time greatest. Here we go. And it's incomplete. It's final, a close one to the very end. 13-10. That's going to do it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying goodbye.